Welcome to WebStylePress. Animate animated SVG via image tag or IMG tag. Confusing, right? No. Basically, IMG tag does not allow SVG animations. Although you can use IMG HTML tags for SVG files like this. IMG, SRC, and then this is our SVG that is animated. Save. Refresh. But this is an animated SVG file and it's meant to show animation, but it's not. Let me show you. This is our animated SVG file. If you have SVG animated file, how would you place it in HTML? You can use object tag. Like this, object type image slash svg plus xml data, and here will be the svg file. Object tag, refresh. See, this is animating. I created this icon by using figma and iconify plugin. I exported it in SVG format. Then I animated it in another program. Now this is straightforward HTML. You can use IMG or object tag as you prefer. But there are scenarios when you only have IMG tag for SVG. For example, WordPress. You can say that you can use code editor or page builder to use HTML and use object for SVG. Okay, what about you are using Elementor? You can say that Elementor page builder has got HTML support. Okay, what about in case you have created a loop template that displays custom post types and your SVG is coming as a custom field? In that case, you only have image tag or IMG tag that will support dynamic tags that will accept custom fields. So there are conditions when you have less freedom or choices. How would you animate SVG in that condition? By using IMG or image tag? Answer is, you can use IMG tag or image tag for SVG and it will display SVG, but it will not animate. Next, you can use DOM manipulation to create object tag next to image, get image source and insert that source into object, then you can hide that image. By doing this, your SVG will be animating in web page. We are gonna do that via jQuery and vanilla JavaScript. I have got Twitter Bootstrap for basic styling. I have got custom.css linked with this HTML file and I have got jQuery. Then I have got custom.js file at the bottom. This is our CSS file to just control size of image and object. Here is our JavaScript file. Now we will hide the object. We will use image. Consider that we have got this image and we've got this SVG file as source for this image and we have to animate it. We have to convert this image into this object via JavaScript. And we have got container class and inside that container we have got image. We have to create and insert object tag inside this container. When DOM will be ready, get image source. Get the source URL for this image and store it in IMG source. we will be creating this object. Only here we will insert this source. Let's use backticks. Now we have created this object and we have placed this image source inside it. So this is what we are going to insert in our container. Next, we will hide actual image. Container.hide, or we can even remove it because we don't need it. Then container append this SVG. Save, and here stop propagation. So append object that we created in same area where image was present. So now we have this image inside this container, and let's try this. Refresh. And this is our animated SVG. If we take a look at it, inspect the element. And we have got this object. We have got this commented line. We don't need it. Now, save, refresh. So inside container, we don't have image tag now. That was present in HTML. We have got object now. So here we had image, but we turned it into object to display SVG animation. We did this by using jQuery. Now we will do it via vanilla JavaScript. Document dot add event listener DOM content loaded. Then fire function. So we added event listener to DOM ready state and fired a function named as result. This is that function result. Let's copy this whole thing. We will comment this jQuery now, and here is our code. So now this dollar sign will turn into document.query selector. Similarly, this one document.query selector and document.query selector. And then this attribute will become get attribute. This line will be same. This remove will be same. And then this append will change. So instead of append, we will use inner HTML is equal to. This SVG. Let's try it. Refresh. And we have got similar result. Inspect element. Now we can even hide the jQuery. And this is just vanilla JavaScript now. And our SVG is being animated. and we had only image tag for SVG. So one more thing, image will load, then it will hide or will be removed, and object with SVG will show up. Page contents will experience a jerk. To avoid that, hide image from beginning via CSS. Container image, display none, use this. So keep it hidden from the start so that UX will be consistent. JavaScript can use a hidden element, so don't worry. And that's that. In real web development, you have to improvise. Doing a thing is easy, but how you will do it in a particular condition, that is important, and that is what you need to learn as a software engineer. Alright, thanks for watching this video. Like, share, subscribe, stay tuned, and I will see you in the next video.